Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to talk about the origin of the hybridization model. Now, back in the 1920s, there was a scientist, Linus Pauling, a famous scientist, and he, like other chemists, knew quite a bit about the molecule methane. He knew that methane was a simple molecule. It had a formula of CH4. It had an atomic geometry about carbon of tetrahedral. That carbon had bond angles about it. The HCH bond angles were 109.5. And lastly, they knew that all the CH bonds were equal. Now, this last fact is kind of interesting, because if we look at a carbon atom, we know that carbon atom has four atomic orbitals in its valence shell: an S, a PX, a PY, and a PZ. And so how could you take these four different atomic orbitals and get out four equivalent CH bonds? So Pauling speculated that maybe what was happening was these orbitals were being combined in a process called hybridization. And the four atomic orbitals, the S and the three P's, were being combined into four equivalent, what we call SP3 hybrids. And that 3 is written as a subscript, and it represents that there are 3 P orbitals and 1 S orbital combined together to get 4 equivalent orbitals. Note that we put in 4 orbitals. 4 orbitals went in, 4 orbitals come out. This is important because, you know, we still follow the octet rule when we think about hybridization, and the octet rule is based on 8 electrons, and those 8 electrons fit into 4 orbitals. So we need to preserve the number of orbitals as we go through the hybridization process. So this was Linus Pauling's idea. Let's make these hybrid orbitals. We would make these four equivalent orbitals, and the equivalent orbitals would very nicely explain how our CH bonds were all equivalent. And this worked really nicely. And Pauling didn't just develop the idea of SP3 hybridization. He also came up with the idea of having SP hybridization. SP2 and SP hybridization. Now, properly speaking, hybridization works best on second row elements. It's not exclusive to second row elements, but, you know, Pauling developed it when he's working on carbon, so it really works best on carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen. We'll sometimes apply it to the halogens and other elements, but really it's for the second row elements, especially carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen. And just like Pauling, we're going to use the model of hybridization to predict things like the geometry about our second row element atom centers, and the bond angles about these types of elements. So it's a really useful, flexible method for predicting geometries and bond angles.